Hey, I'm Kevin, coming to you from Mailchimp. Thank you so much for joining me. In this video, I'll show you how to reach your most valuable customers with predictive segmentation, one of our powerful AI tools. These types of segments give you an idea of who's more likely to buy again and who might spend more money over time. So first, I'll start with an overview of some pre-built segments. Then I'll explain how Mailchimp calculates customer lifetime value and purchase likelihood. And finally, I'll touch on how you can use predictive analytics to plan a campaign. But before we get started, here's what you need to know to follow along with this tutorial. Predictive segmentation is a paid feature available on standard plans or higher. If you have any questions about plans and their capabilities, check out our pricing page. For Mailchimp to accurately predict who your best customers may be, you'll need to connect an e-commerce store with plenty of relevant data. For guidance on connecting your store to Mailchimp, visit the integrations playlist on our YouTube channel or simply stop by our trusty help center. Now, on to the fun stuff. Let's go ahead and jump into our Mailchimp account and explore predictive segmentation. So we'll start by navigating to the audience dashboard. And then in the current audience dropdown, we'll choose the potted planner because it's connected to our e-commerce store. What's the potted planner, you may ask? Simply a fictitious plant store that we use for educational purposes only. Okay, I think we're all set here. So moving on, let's unpack how predictive segments differ from other pre-built segments. In general, we group your contacts into segments based on shared characteristics and behavior. So in the tag section, the Fern segment is made up of contacts who've clicked on a specific promotion. After clicking the link, they were added to a marketing automation and tagged with the label Fern. And Mailchimp automatically grouped these contacts based on a shared tag, not a guess or a prediction of contacts' behavior or demographics. So to sum it all up, a pre-built segment is informed by something that Mailchimp knows for sure. And a predictive segment kind of works like a weather forecast. There's plenty of info to make an estimate, but we can't 100% guarantee an outcome. So on that note, let's go ahead and take a look at predicted demographics. And to put it simply, we use data science to predict the age and gender of your contacts. These predictions are generated from shared Mailchimp account info from around the world. When you're ready to build a campaign, you first have to decide which demographic you'd like to target. So for example, here in the age range section, it could be contacts who are likely between 25 and 34 years old. At the moment, we don't have enough info for most of these demographics, so I'll choose a segment that has some data. I'll head to the gender section and highlight the arrow icon next to unknown. Now the option to target with campaign appears. I won't click this right now, but I'll go over starting a campaign a little bit later. Demographic info can be used to refine the scope of a campaign. But to get a better picture of who your customers are, it's also helpful to look into their purchasing behavior. So let's move to the e-commerce section, and I'll walk you through two of our favorite predictive segments, customer lifetime value and purchase likelihood. Both of these segments forecast a customer's future buying behavior. On one hand, customer lifetime value, or CLV, may help to predict who's likely to spend more money over time, while purchase likelihood is an estimate of who's likely to buy again, which is info that may help you retain your business. These two segments sound similar, but they are different. And let me explain with a few examples. So let's say you have two customers who are equally likely to buy again. The person who spends more money on average would likely have a higher CLV. In another scenario, you have a customer who made a few large purchases. Let's say they pretty much bought everything in your store, but it was a year ago. While their CLV may be higher, their purchase likelihood would actually be low compared to someone who makes a few small purchases at your store each week. So that sort of explains the what behind the CLV and purchase likelihood. But how do they work? Well, Mailchimp uses mathematical models to compare averages from your store to customer-specific variables. We then take these calculations and predict if a customer's CLV or purchase likelihood is low, moderate, or high. Earlier, I said I'd go over starting a campaign. I think now's a good time to go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna head over to the CLV panel and highlight the high segment. The option to target with campaign appears, just like it did when we were working on predicted demographics. Next, I'll click on the arrow icon by target with campaign, which takes us to a pop-up. Here, you're prompted to say something to the segment of your audience. I'm thinking I would say something about a rewards program Or you can offer a referral bonus if you see customers publicly praising your business. We'll get more into how you can target contacts later, but whatever messaging strategy you decide on, you'll be able to connect with your audience through a number of channels. You can create an email, create an ad, or create a postcard. I think that about covers starting a campaign, so let's go ahead and click the X to close this pop-up and return to the audience dashboard. A lot goes into calculating CLV and purchase likelihood. I want you to have a better understanding of where our predictions are coming from. So let's go over a few customer-specific variables that Mailchimp uses. First, customer age. That refers to how long a contact has been a customer. In other words, the amount of time that has passed since their first purchase. Following that is the time between the first and last purchase. So in this case, the last purchase means the most recent one. Then there's the time since the most recent purchase. Nothing tricky here. It's just how long it's been since a customer has made their latest purchase. And then there's frequency, which is how many times a customer has bought from your store. And lastly, spend amount. That's the total amount of contact is spent in your e-commerce store. Spend amount is not factored into purchase likelihood. It's only used for CLV. All right, you made it through. I know that got kind of technical, but I think it's important to be upfront with how we make predictions. After all, Mailchimp takes data integrity and accuracy seriously. We only show you CLV and purchase likelihood when we're confident your store has enough relevant and consistent data. When your store has enough quality data for valid predictions, it's time to reach out to your contacts. I'm going to suggest a few ways you can use CLV and purchase likelihood to fine-tune your targeting. So what if your goal is to win back some customers, right? You can send a re-engagement campaign to contacts who have had a low purchase likelihood, or maybe you'd like to launch a retention campaign, but you're not really sure who to reach out to. You can consider customers with a high purchase likelihood. There's also an opportunity to raise customer CLV. As you analyze moderate and low CLV segments, try thinking about a few things. What are their habits? How can you get them to better see the value that you offer? And what sort of campaign can help you achieve that goal? These are just some points you can use for marketing inspiration. You can use predictive segments as a base and fine-tune your targeting even more with conditions like location, purchase date, and many others. But keep in mind, the type of conditions you're able to add vary by plan, so check your pricing page for details. And with that, we've covered everything for today's video. Thank you so much for hanging in there. And for your next campaign, give predictive segmentation a try. It may help you target smarter and deliver more personalized messages. And if you want a little more guidance, drop by our help center or feel free to contact our support team. Thank you.